I wasn't planning on making any videos today, but guys, looks like it's our turn. It finally freaking happened. My belt just snapped, the battery light came on, and my coolant temp started to go up, and all of a sudden I just shut the car off. It looks like our belt is completely destroyed. And it looks like the squeak I heard a couple days ago might have been that. So I gotta call a tow truck now and get this sorted in the worst spot. I'm like 5 minutes away from home, but I'll keep you guys updated. Well guys, it finally happened to me. I know a lot of you guys have had this issue in the past. I'm filming on my phone now right now. Hopefully the quality and the sound is okay. But it happens. There's nothing I can do about it. The belt snapped. Technically the car was still driving, but I was driving and the battery light came on. And all of a sudden, you know, I called a friend and he said, well, if it's driving fine, you should be all right. But then the battery light came on. He was like, turn the car off and turn it back on. When I turned it back on, the coolant temps went all the way up, immediately shut the car off and just pulled off to the side of the road. So thank God there was no coolant spillage. It looks like it's just the belt and the they need to rely on the compressor or whatever the heck it is. So I'm just waiting on a tow truck. They said about an hour, which sucks. The dealership is 60 miles from here, so that's going to be an expensive tow as well. So yeah, fun day. Just an update for you guys. The tow truck said it would take about 2.5 hours to get the car. So it's already been about an hour and a half past. I just went home to take some personal belongings out of the car. I'm coming back just to stay here till they get here, because I got to give them the key fob so they can drop it at the dealership drop box and hopefully get this sorted. I'm going to go see my advisor, service advisor, tomorrow morning here at my dealership and talk to him, let him know what happened, you know, let him know, bring my TSB documentation. My VIN falls under the TSB issue. So I was just talking about this to you guys the other day, that if your car is within a certain VIN, you know, you got to take it up to the dealership so you can get the TSB performed. And here we go. It happened to me. My pulley chirped 2 days ago. Two days ago. About a week ago. And today, just normal driving. My battery light comes on, and I'm like, that's one of the first signs people have described on the forums that that's what happens to them. So I immediately just kind of slowed down, and then I saw my coolant temperature start to rise. I pulled over immediately and shut the car off, and I just caught the belt starting to rip. So I think we caught it on time. Maybe that's a warning sign for you guys. Look out for a chirp or a humming noise, or that's what something else that people have said. You know, nothing I can do now and just get the car fixed to the dealership, see what they say. If they don't want to take care of it, then we'll go from there. But other than that, I don't think the tensioners are damaged. Like some cases, people have had to pay thousands of dollars for damaged tensioners. I think it's just maybe the belt needs to be replaced and realigned. So I'll keep you guys posted, and we're pulling up to the car here, get some more stuff out of it.
Yeah. This whole piece is gonna hit here. It might still hit a little bit.
Yeah.
But not as bad.
Okay.
How long have you had the car for?
I've had it for 15 months. Yeah.
All year.
You
drive this in the snow? Or you park it?
All year.
How
did
you do
it? Great, it's all-wheel drive. Drives pretty good. Here you go, guys. Getting on the tow truck now. Oh, boy. That's a little scary. That's pretty close, but I think you got it. Off she goes. Making sure my exhaust is not hitting the ground. Oh, that is close. I think you'll just about make it right on there.
You know, I almost lowered the car another half inch before today.
I almost lowered the car another half inch before today.
I wouldn't do that.
It would have made your job a hell of a lot harder.
I wouldn't have been able to.
Yeah, you probably wouldn't have been able to.
See, that's where some of those newer tow trucks,
yeah,
they can sit this, or they go down just a tad,
yep, before
they're almost level with the ground.
Yep.
Those are the ones for the lower rider car.
Man. Well, this guy is legit. He put a piece of wood down so he wouldn't touch the ground on the way up, which is great. Loving it.
Well, guys, the Q60's on the tow truck now. It's like 35 degrees. I am freezing. I should have dressed a little warmer, but that's life. This guy's been really helpful. He's been able to get the car on there without scratching anything. If I would have lowered it even like another half inch like I was talking about, probably would have got it.
Off she goes. Time to get into the Mazda Mobile that we got here. Oh, I was about to say, you didn't start. Oh, it's been a long night, guys, but you know, these things happen. As I mentioned, there's nothing you can do about it. Just kind of got to go with the flow and trust the process. So I'll keep you guys posted and updated how everything goes. I'll be at the dealership tomorrow morning to get a loaner car because I need one to get to work. So I'll get a ride up there to the dealership and grab a car for, you know, until they get this car fixed. And I don't know how long it's going to take. But the tow truck guy that just came, even though I waited a long time because everyone was really busy apparently, he was really nice. He made sure my car didn't get scratched getting on the truck or anything of that sort. So, I mean, that's what he does for a living. So I'm really grateful. Other than that, guys, this is going to be it for tonight. Stay tuned for the next update, and just know that, you know, this is probably going to happen to one of you guys at some point in your ownership of your VR30 if your VIN falls within those certain dates that the issue was not addressed 4 years later in production, and apparently people still having this problem. Mine is a 2017, by the way, so in case you guys didn't know, yeah, it's a 2017. It was built in March. The TSB says it'll have to be anywhere between, well, it has to be built before May 27th of 2017, which it was. So I'll be going to the dealership tomorrow and letting them know, you know, that it was. I'm sure they can pull the VIN up and see that, but we'll handle that when we get there. Oh, I love my wife's car. This thing is amazing. It has heads-up display, red leather, carbon fiber, paddle shifters. It's fully loaded sport model. It's not the fastest car in the world, but it's a great miles per gallon. Maybe I'll feature it in the channel one of these days. Enough of me rambling on, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I'll keep you guys updated. See you guys soon.